Hi, and welcome to this ForNAV Coffee Break. My name is René Brümmel, I'm a product specialist at ForNAV, and I will be your presenter today. As this coffee break is live, you can ask your questions via the GoToWebinar question window. We will answer them at the end of the coffee break. Today, we're going to add digital signatures to your Business Central reports. Digitally signing a PDF document is an easy way of proving that you created and sent it. Therefore, it protects you and your clients from malicious invoices. Digitally signing the output of a ForNAV report is as easy as uploading the certificate. Let's go and have a look. To demonstrate adding a digital signature, I'm going to use these steps. Prerequisites, what do I need to get going? In step 2, I will upload my certificate. In step 3, I will add the certificate to my report layout. In step 4, I will check the signature on the document. Let's start with the first step. Today, I will add a digital signature in a Business Central on-premise server with the Business Central 2022 Wave 1 release. I've installed the universal code version of the ForNAV customizable report pack, and I've executed the step-by-step wizard from the assisted setup to get started. Of course, everything we do today is also available on the Business Central SaaS environment. I also have the ForNAV Designer installed on my PC. The ForNAV Designer can be downloaded from the ForNAV website. The first thing we need to do, of course, to sign a document is to get a certificate for digitally signing documents. You will need a PFX certificate file. There are many certificate issuers that sell these certificates, so we will not discuss that here. Once you have the signature with the key, you can simply upload it in the ForNAV storage table. So let's go and have a look. Go to Business Central and find the ForNAV file storage table. And the ForNAV file storage table is a table. There we go. Can't type and talk at the same time. The ForNAV file storage table is a table where you can store files. We use it for PDF files, for watermarks, for logos, etc. And we can also use it for our certificate. So I will make a new record. I will say the code is certificate and the type is PFX. I will import my certificate PFX file, which is this one. And then I need to add a description. I will call it PDF signing certificate. And finally, a PFX signature has a key, and that key needs to be stored. And to do that, we have created a new field inside the ForNAV file storage table. It's going to be released in ForNAV 7.0, which is not currently out at the time of this recording. But this is going to be a new field where you can store the key, and that key will be stored nicely with masked characters, so it will be safe. So that's adding the certificate in the ForNAV file storage table. And the second thing we need to do is to tell ForNAV to sign the actual PDF file. And we can do that by adding some JavaScript to the report. So back to Business Central, find a suitable report, and let's play with the invoice today. You can sign any ForNAV report in any extension. Just the invoice is a document that's used very often, so we use it in demos all the time. And the first thing I need to do is, of course, I need to load the certificate into my report, and I can do that by simply adding a record with a reference to the ForNAV file storage. So I will add that one. I am not going to add a link reference and a link because I need to get a specific file based on a specific with a specific key. Of course, you can get a file connected to either the user ID or the customer or a dimension or something else. In this case, I just need a single record inside my file storage. And we're going to call this the PFX certificate, because you may have multiple references to the ForNAV file storage. And then, of course, I need to specify which record I want. And I want the record with the code cert and with the type PFX. And finally, I need to calculate my data field. So the data is stored in a blob field. And in order to use that inside the ForNAV report, you need to calculate it. So I've added my calculated field. So that's the first step. And the second step in the on-pre report, I need to tell ForNAV to sign this document with this certificate. So I'm going to go to curry report, print the settings, sign certificate, and I will assign that with my PFX certificate.data, which is the actual blob field, the actual certificate. And then, of course, I need to sign it with the password, and that will be my PFX certificate.key field. So, in short, I've loaded the PFX certificate in a blob field in my ForNAV report, and I've assigned the curry report printer setting sign.certificate and password with the relevant data. Finally, we can run the report and test our certificate. Please be aware that not every PDF viewer will display the certificate details, so we will use Adobe Acrobat for this specific demo. So let's hit preview. Of course, we need to sign in again. Now we'll send this to a PDF document. That will get me the PDF document, and you will notice if I open this in Edge that I don't get any signature information at all. However, if I open it with Adobe, you will notice that in Adobe says signed and all signatures are valid. And if I look at the signature panel, you will notice that it is signed by Redden Bundle with the email address support@reddenbundle.com. Which is just a PDF PFX certificate that I use for other stuff and for demos and other things. So that is how you digitally sign a PDF document. Let's recap what we just did. The first thing we did was to get a PFX certificate and store it in the ForNAV file storage table. We could then get the certificate in the ForNAV report layout by using a record and set the certificate with JavaScript. Once we saved the report as a PDF file, ForNAV automatically signed it with the stored certificate. Of course, you can make your setup more complex than we did in this coffee break. You can, for instance, get a separate signature per user, per business unit, per email account, etc. Thank you for listening to me so far. I can see we don't have any questions at the moment, so I will wrap up this coffee break. If you want to know more about ForNAV, or if you want to download the ForNAV Designer and Converter, please visit our website. If you want to install ForNAV in Business Central Cloud, please visit the Microsoft App Source. You can watch more videos about ForNAV on our YouTube channel, and if you have any questions about ForNAV, please email them to support@fornav.com. For a full list of upcoming and recorded coffee breaks, please visit fornav.com/coffee break. Thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.